Hi guys, today I'm going to change the thermal pads on an ASUS Turbo 1080 Ti, a card with a lot of temperature issues, especially if it's not in a ventilated case. The card does have the advantage that it exhausts all the air out of the back. But the downside is that the cooler is rather small, and another downside is that, well, it's very loud thanks to its tiny single fan. This card had already been serviced before with a Arctic MX4, so that the paste has been changed, but for this video, I will show you how to change the thermal pads on both the memory and the VRMs, and we'll see if this has any impact on the temperatures. I don't expect it to be any different, since the temperature was already at around 76 degrees Celsius after applying the Arctic thermal paste. But yeah, we'll see. First of all, this graphics card has a lot of screws, so bear with me while I take them all out. So yeah, let's start. It's best to use magnetic screwdriver so that you don't lose the parts. Yeah, without further ado, let's get going. Now, next thing, you need to carefully take out the cooler. In this case, it was pretty easy since it was recently serviced. And as you'll see in a second, there's a lot of thermal goo in here. But first, I'll take out the LED. 2-pin LED, and now we have access to the board. Carefully pry out the cable here, the cooler cable. Here it is. So now the thermal pads, they seem to be 1.5 millimeters, but let's double check. I have several sizes from Thermal Right, Extreme Odyssey. This is a 2 millimeter, and a small patch of 1.5. This seems to be 1.5. But since the thermal take, the thermal right paste is kind of squishy, it's okay to use a 2 millimeter pad. However, this is not the case with any thermal pads. Some pads are slightly harder, and when putting the thing back together, you might not get a good pressure on the GPU. So be very careful when replacing. Try to replace the pads with something very similar in size to what you have. Another thing to note is when replacing the thermal pads on the memory, in order to save some material, try to cut the pads down to size and don't use strips like this, because you will waste a lot of material, a lot of pad by doing this. Yes, you can do it on the VRM side, but there's no need to do it like this on the memory side. Now, I'm going to first clean out this huge amount of thermal paste in here. And yeah, let's get on to it. I'm using some nail polish remover. This is fine for removing the thermal paste on the GPU and on the VRMs, etc. But be careful when you use it on plastic, because it tends to degrade it. Okay, next I'm going to remove the old pads. Yes, they seem to be exactly 1.5 millimeters. I'm going to use Thermal Grizzly because it's better than MX4. Not by much, but this card can take any help it can get to stay cool. So an Odyssey thermal pad 85 by 45 millimeters is enough, is just enough for the whole card with a few squared centimeters left over. When applying thermal paste, you don't need to apply it evenly on the surface. You just need to have enough in the center and it will spread out by itself. Now the process in reverse. You need to connect the fan, then connect the LED. And then carefully line up the holes. Yeah, that's it. Now, the actual radiator for the GPU is separated from the plate, so it will slide around a little. So you need to push down until one of the screws catches. Then it should be good. Then work in a diagonal pattern to the next screw. Make sure you push down. Right. Continue with the next one. And the fourth, which I'm gonna now. Gradually screw them in with the same diagonal pattern, making sure that the radiator stays flush. The screws will stop at some point, so it's a hard stop. You cannot over tighten them. So here it is. Now let's start testing it and see if this made a difference.